My friend told me that he was looking for work, so I said to him, why don't you write a story and, you know, then you can direct it or do something about it. So as an exercise, he and I sat down together to find a story. So he said, a man who wants to kill himself. And I said, a girl on the train. Now we tried to put these two ideas together and do a brainstorm. Nothing happened as a result. But this idea stayed in my mind. And after months and perhaps years, I found myself thinking more and more about it. And one day I just wrote it. That's how Jab We Met began. Then I narrated it to Preeti Zinta, who is a very important figure for Jab We Met. Because she was actually the first person, the first outsider who really liked the film. It's because of Preeti Zinta that I realized that people are actually going to perhaps, like, there's something good in this, because I had never any confidence on this story. It began at a point where I met Shahid. Somebody introduced me to Shahid and Shahid to me. I guess saying that I have a script for him and telling me that he's interested in working with me. Neither were true, maybe. You know, but we were set up together and we will always thank the gentleman who did so. But then we just started talking and Shahid said, you have a story about a train. So then I started telling him this offhandedly. And then he said, what, you think that I'm suited? I said, no, I don't. See, the reason I never approached you is because you're very young for this part. But then I while meeting him, I'd never met him before, but then meeting him, I realized that he is actually kind of more mature than his look or his age. And then he wore spectacles and all that to try to fit in. And then he asked me who suits it, who suits the girl. So I said my first choice was Kareena. And at that time I tried to speak to her and, you know, I hadn't been able to basically, like, get across when I was trying to make it earlier. But now I met her because of this, and I narrated to Shahid and Kareena kind of together, and they liked it. But I was going to make it with Bobby at that point of time, so I didn't know how to work this out. But ultimately, it had dragged on with Bobby for a long time, like for years, and I was just sitting at home, and so then I went ahead and made this one. I feel Shahid was the most positive person on the film. About the film, he was more confident about the film than me. Kareena loved the film, I think, a lot, and she is not the person who, once doing something, will ever quarrel with anything. So she just submits, and she did. Shahid liked everything, but he was just also, he was trying that it turns out the best way. There was never anything that he wanted differently. I think there was a time when about music there was a little question, because there was Aaoge Jab Tumo Sajna, which was such a slow song that everybody in the unit, like, hated it initially. And they thought, what the hell is this very old-fashioned Buddha Wala Gana doing in our film, which is a young people's film, etc. Some of us who liked it, very few of us, were very scared to even play it on the shoot. But there was no discord. We have nothing really to shoot tomorrow. We can't waste the time, because time is money. So what we do is that we decide to shoot the Ratlam scenes in Manali. That wo gali to lagi rahi na, aise ho sakta hai. Wo jo gali hai ki Ratlam ki galiyon mein ghoom rahi hu, that's actually in Manali. That hotel descent scene that happens, it's supposed to be in Ratlam again. That's another place in Manali. Something else is Lonavala. Something else is somewhere in Punjab. So that improvisation was happening so much. We were not really so much improvising on the script. See, improvising is not only changing the script. You have to improvise a script in order to make it come to life, to shoot it. We were doing that. We were not changing the script. I remember one scene being very difficult to execute, only because there was a honeycomb of bees on top of Kareena's head. And this was the last scene, which is the most romantic scene, where she comes to Aditya, and she wants to be with him, and that final climactic, cathartic scene. And light was going, and that was the only time we could do it, and blah blah blah, all those reasons were there. And then there was this madhumakhi ka chhatta. This madhumakhi had already bitten 2-3 people of the unit, and Kareena, of course, didn't want to, like, be bitten by this. at the same time, we knew that if there is a sting on her face or on Shahid's face, then they can't shoot anymore, you know, because it's their faces, like it's okay for it to bite me, like I'd suffer in pain, but that's it. We took the chance. Everyone was so scared because the light was making it hot and the honey, the flies were coming, like the bees were coming off and biting everyone. We were tense about how it's going, how they are going to handle it, because there were still some scenes to be done. And you know, immediately after somebody breaks up, it's a little hard. So immediately after the breakup, there were some scenes, but they did it very nicely. They were very professional about it. So I didn't have, there was no trouble. Jab We Met is as much and perhaps more my film than any other. Because it was at a time when so many people weren't there, you know, collaborators. Second thing is that beyond a point you forget. Now that I have made 7 films, one of them will be somebody's favorite or least favorite, and they will tell me about it. Sometimes I used to feel, why they were always talking about Jab We Met, why aren't they talking about Love Aajkal as much, or why aren't they talking about other films as much? But then, you know what, they do start, luckily for me, I think at this point of time, most people are not talking about Jab We Met. You know, my other films have also got recognition in their own ways. Like, there is a set of people that believes Rockstar is the one to talk about. There is a set of people, and I did a poll recently in my own ex-college, Hindu, the present students, and I said, just raise hands and tell me which movie of mine you like. The Highway one, unexpectedly, small film, small budget film, newcomers. But that's the film that those people like. To begin with, I don't read critics. I have, for my second or third film onwards, I realized that actually it's not helping me. It's actually just, everyone seems to have their own like agendas or their own concepts. So I don't read critics for my films or any other films. Not that I have, all of them are my personal friends and I like all of them, but it just doesn't work for me, right? And I don't even claim that I make every film so uniquely different from each other. Maybe not. I do what comes to me and I try to do it the best. So I'm not going to offer any explanation, and I really don't want a certificate from any critic either.